Hey, what's going on everyone? Greg here, and it looks like we're getting a lot more details on what we can expect the iPhone 11's final design to look like, including a lot more leaks from reputable sources like OnLeaks and even some concept renders and images from him as well. And of course, our favorite supply chain leaker, Ming-Chi Kuo, also has some new details all regarding the iPhone 11. So let's get started with the video, and it seems that all that people want to talk about with these iPhone 11 leaks is the giant camera hump on the back of the iPhone. So this year's iPhone will have three cameras on the back, including the normal wide-angle camera, a zoom lens. We don't know what range of zoom it will be. There have been some rumors saying Apple will increase it from a 2x zoom, maybe to a 3x zoom, maybe all the way up to a 5x zoom. And that third lens is rumored to be an ultra wide angle lens. We've seen a lot of flagship smartphones start to include ultra wide lenses. LG was one of the first ones, but we've seen other people in the industry, particularly Samsung this year, come out with a smartphone that has three lenses on the back. So an ultra wide, normal, and then that zoom lens. Supposedly the rear camera system will also include a bump up in the megapixel department. So it's going from a 12 megapixel sensor to a 14 megapixel sensor. Now the ultra wide angle camera will only go to a 10 megapixel sensor. I'm guessing it's going to be the same exact sensor, obviously, but when you're using that wider depth of field, it's only able to capture the 10 megapixels on that image sensor. As for the design of that camera lens itself, we've seen a couple of iterations floating on the internet now, but it seems like Apple is going with that squared off design in the top corner. Traditionally, we've also seen that this camera bump will be blacked out like you would traditionally see in an iPhone camera, but recent leaks have said that Apple will be opting for the same back color as whatever iPhone you're buying. So if you're buying a silver iPhone, the back of the camera would be silver. If you're buying a black iPhone, the back of that camera bump would be black. This also lines up with recent leaks that the back of the iPhone will be made from a single piece of glass. Having it made out of that single piece of glass, apparently this will make the camera bump smoother and less noticeable. Now overall, based on these leaks, I'm pretty excited about the addition of a third camera on the iPhone. After using the Galaxy S10e for review, I was really impressed with the ultra wide angle lens on it. Now, as for the design of the iPhone 11's camera bump, if you go anywhere else on YouTube, anywhere else on the internet, you just see videos and comments saying that this is an ugly design. And it may surprise you, but I'm not one of those people, and that is for a couple of reasons. Number one being that this isn't the final design. These are 3D images. These are CAD images of the iPhone 11, and there aren't a lot of the finer details implemented into these designs. Apple's final designs are usually a lot more polished than the leaks that we are seeing, and I have precedent to back me up on this. Just take a look at this iPhone 10 leak. At the time, this was a 3D image floating around, and if you look at the back of this design, you can see that it just doesn't look as good as the final design we got with the iPhone 10. I'd also like to mention that when the iPhone 10 was rumored and when people thought it was called the iPhone 8 at that time, people were freaking out that the camera placement was different, that it switched from a horizontal camera to a vertical camera. And I can't help but think that with these iPhone 11 leaks showing off these three cameras, even if you think that bump is hideous, we just haven't seen how it will be incorporated into the final design. My second point would be is that a lot of people are saying that the design is inherently ugly and that Apple wouldn't go with a design that doesn't look as good as the previous design. But I always like to go back to the old Steve Jobs quote when he talks about design. Most people make the mistake of thinking design is what it looks like. People think it's the veneer. That designers are handed this box and told, make it look good. That's not what we think design is. It's not just what it looks like and feels like. Design is how it works. And that's what I want to reiterate. Design is ultimately how it works, not how it looks. We just have no way of knowing what the camera system will do and if this arrangement or the size of this camera hump will lead to a significant improvement in the photos we take every day. Last year, we saw Apple implement the Smart HDR feature where it combined different exposures of a photo to give us a photo that had a more consistent exposure, better dynamic range, and more detail. These three lenses could be positioned in this way to give us a feature that maybe goes beyond smart HDR and combines all three camera lenses at the same time taking a photo. From there, AI could stitch these photos together to give us a much more detailed image. And we've also already seen leaks that might match up to this feature that when you take a photo with the iPhone 11, in software, say if you accidentally cut someone out of the picture, you would go back and be able to edit it to expand it to a wider field of view, maybe with that wide angle lens, and then you would be able to capture what you missed from either a photo or a video. The physical size of that camera bump could also be because Apple is adding in a much larger image sensor. Having a larger sensor could let more light in and of course just lead to better photos. One of the reasons why DSLRs take such great photos is because they have bigger image sensors inside of them. Also, maybe the strange arrangement of these lenses could be a feature where it deals with augmented reality. We've heard rumors that Apple is secretly working on an AR headset, which could launch as soon as this year or next year, and maybe this will be a way for people to create content with their iPhones by having these three lenses. This will be able to create an augmented space that you can easily capture, record, and create with your iPhone. And there's still just tons of details that we don't know yet or why Apple is going with this design. And when the iPhone 11 is released and we hear the story for why Apple chose this design, I think it will be a lot clearer to people why Apple chose to go with this bigger squared off camera. Moving away from the camera while we're still on the back of the phone, supposedly the iPhone 11 is going to get a redesigned glass. We've heard rumors that it's going to be a frosted glass. If you ask me, it sounds a lot like the Google Pixel 3. And if you go back and watch my video, that was one of the design elements I liked about the Pixel 3. I actually liked how that softer glass felt in the hand. It'll be interesting to see what changes this frosted glass brings, but I hope that it makes the phone a little less slippery. As for the front of the iPhone, it looks like it's going to be mostly unchanged. So we're still getting two iPhone models, the iPhone 11 and of course the iPhone 11 Max, and they're both going to keep the same 5.8 and 6.5 inch OLED screens. Apparently there's rumors that maybe the bezel will shrink slightly, but apparently it's going to be so slight that it will be barely even noticeable. One of the constant rumors we've been hearing is that the notch will shrink on the iPhone 11, but recent rumors seem to indicate that this is not true and the notch will stay the same size. One notable change might be coming to the front-facing camera. So the front-facing camera is supposedly going to get a bump from a 7 megapixel sensor to a 12 megapixel sensor. It also looks like we're getting a special black lens coating which should hide the camera from sight. So we're hearing reports that the iPhone XS will be 0.4 millimeters thicker. Now this could be thicker for a couple of things. It could be to accommodate the camera hump on the back, and it could also be to accommodate the bigger batteries that are rumored for the iPhone 11 and iPhone 11 Max with battery capacities that are up to 25% more in size. These bigger batteries are also in the phone for a new rumored feature, which is bilateral charging. What this feature would allow you to do is to charge someone else's phone on the back of your iPhone. However, I think that the reason that Apple will be adding this feature isn't so much that you'll be able to charge someone else's iPhone, it's that you'll be able to charge your Apple Watch and your AirPods from your iPhone, so you won't need a separate cable, especially when you're traveling. You could just take your iPhone, and then if your Apple Watch battery is low or if your AirPods battery is low, you could just stick it on the back of your iPhone. Another rumor is that the mute switch will also be getting a redesign very similar to the old iPad mute switch. So the mute switch will work up and down and be a rounded shape rather than working side to side in that more squared off shape. As for other features, we can of course expect an A13 chip with significant performance improvements. Supposedly the iPhone 11 will also be getting ultra wideband support to help it with indoor positioning. This could also make its way into a feature for augmented reality inside of the Maps app. So say you're inside of a mall and you need walking directions to a store, virtual arrows could point you in that direction. Also, Apple will be sticking with the Lightning port for better or worse, so no USB-C. However, there have been recent rumors that Apple will be shipping an 18 watt power brick, so fast charging might be enabled out of the box, and that would include a USB-C to Lightning cable, so USB-C on the power brick, but Lightning still on the iPhone. And as for price, we haven't heard any rumors of Apple lowering the price. We know that iPhone sales were lower than Apple wanted them to be, but we haven't heard any indications if Apple might drop the price down $100. So I think it's fair to assume that these iPhones will probably be starting around the same price, $999 starting price, and then another $100 for the max version. Honestly, although the external design of this phone isn't changing, I think this might be a bigger upgrade than some people are expecting it to be. If I had to compare it to another iPhone model based on the rumors, this sounds a lot like the iPhone 7, where initially the complaints were that the exterior design of the phone really didn't change at all, but there were a lot of new features. It was the first iPhone to get the second camera lens, and it turned out to be just a great overall phone, and it really sounds like the iPhone 11 is heading in that similar direction with a 3-year design cycle, and then the 2020 iPhone, we can expect to see some more design refreshes. But enough about what I think, let me know what you think in the comments below. Are you excited for the new iPhone 11? What features are you looking forward to? How do you feel about the camera bump on the back of it? Do you think it is a bad design? Do you think it's a good design? Do you think that Apple in the final product will make it look better than these 3D renderings are showing off? If you like the video, make sure you give me a like. If you want to see more from my channel, including future reporting on the iPhone 11 and eventually an iPhone 11 review, make sure you're subscribed. If you want to support the channel in any way, make sure you check out some of the links in the description. And as always, I will see you all in the next video. Take care, everyone.